It's actually 28 and a half inches, but 24, because it worked out just right, 28 and a half inches out through there.
I don't want to throw it.
I was already feeling my shoulder burning, I was like, no.
If you're not using the 5-2 line this month or so, but I put a little bit more on this one, maybe a pound across the whole bed. What I want to do, I want to make sure you understand this. When you plane a plank, it's important that you look at two things. You want to look at a plank that is healthy, good deep green, natural colors, a vivacious color. You don't want to plane a plank that's going past its prime. It'll always be past its prime. It's back toward the stock yard by the pig. That's a run of the bunch. Nine times out of ten, you feed him all summer, he's still a run. You've just wasted a lot of feed on him. Same way about the tomato plants. Healthy plants will start off much better. The key to healthy plants is keep them going faster. When we plant this plant, it's an important thing. You see, I'm taking off all these limbs. They don't need to be there. They're a hindrance to the plant. Now right there is what we're going to leave. We're going to plant him all the way up to his ears, right there. Why do we do that? If you look at this plant, you'll see all those little hairs. All those little hairs are potential roots. You want those underground. That will help feed that plant. It will help stabilize that plant. Besides, you want to make that plant happy. And if you notice, use these and they make good identification. Good identification sticks you can write on them, and it keeps you identified what you got. This is a big beach snake tomato. What I've done here, I've dug up a good hole. I've got a good hole beside this steel stake. So I'm gonna put my fingers on that plank like this. I'm gonna turn that over and get that time or two like that. And I'm going to set this whole thing. Now look here, you see how the roots are going around that? Most people err in putting their plants in too small of containers. This is the right size container. I've got one a little bit smaller, but I would not go anything less than this size here. Do you see that plant? This is a big Brandywine pink. It's a what I used to call an old-timey German plant. That pink leaf looks like a potato plant. These are fantastic tomatoes. These are heirloom tomatoes. These are heirloom. But you can see the roots on the outside of this. It's ready to go on the ground right now. So we're going to put that thing down in the ground. And we're going to set him right there like that. We're going to put this around him. We're going to pull this up. And it wouldn't hurt to put a little bit more. You see, he's planted right there. He's that far from that steel post. When he starts to grow,